all, let me just thank Jolie. And all of you for coming. J Sweet America. J Sweet Freedom. Okay. You know, George Orwell said that in a time of universal defeat, truth is a revolutionary act. And just telling the truth is radical. And truth is the new hate speech. Yes. Think about it. Think about not a week after jihadi slaughtered writers, editors, cartoonists at a French magazine weekly seeking to impose the free speech restrictions under the Sharia, under Islamic law. Here we are in Garland, Texas, across the street from an Islamic conference not in support of freedom of speech. Think about this, but in support of the very ideology that incited those jihadists to slaughter that staff of Charles Hebdo. That's why we're here. We are standing against the most brutal and radical and extreme ideology on the face of the earth. Oh, yeah. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. The president of Egypt, Al-Sisi, has called for a revolution in Islam. He sounds like what the president of the United States should be saying. Yeah. And the president of the United States sounds like an Ayatollah in Iran. It's absurd. The media has cowed and submitted and subdued itself. The media self-enforces the Sharia. The European press ran those cartoons, but the American media wouldn't run them. The nation based on individual rights, the first nation in the history of mankind based on individual rights and freedom, and everything great and noble that we achieved as a nation with a logical fidelity to that principle, has completely by the elite been abandoned. But we, the people, you understand me? You have power. Yeah. 4 years ago, at the site of the largest jihadi attack in the West, at Ground Zero, they sought to build a mega mosque. I bring this up so you understand that the president supported that mosque. At the iftar dinner, you remember, he announced he supported the iftar dinner. The mayor of New York City, not only did his office fill out the papers for the mosque, but he said if we didn't build the mosque, the terrorists will win. This is the world that we're living in. Understand that the media wanted that mosque built. My God, they made Sharif Al-Gamal, the developer, the NBC Man of the Year. But the point is, to this story, tens of thousands of people came to our protest. 35,000 people stood at Ground Zero on 9/11 and said no. And you know what? That mosque was not built. That's why when people say, oh, there's nothing we can do, there's plenty we can do. If history has taught us anything, it's that the individual can change the course of human events. And to look out on this crowd, thousands of patriots and the anti-free speech crowd, the Muslims playing loud music? We are the world. Oh, we know you want to be the world. We got that. Playing loud music to drown us out, that's shutting down free speech. There is a campaign to destroy, smear, and marginalize anyone that speaks critically of jihad and Sharia. Yes. Now listen, in Muslim countries, under the Sharia, it is blasphemy if you offend, insult, or criticize Islam, even if it's true. And they punish you by death. Here in America, they don't execute you, but let me tell you what they do. They destroy your name, they smear you, and they marginalize you just because you speak for free speech. I don't care what you worship. I don't care if you worship a stone. Just don't stone me with it. Yeah. Never forget who you are. Never forget your premise. Your premise is freedom. And those silver-tongued snakes tie people's minds up into knots. Always check your premise. Your premise is freedom. You are standing here. They can have their rally. I don't mind that. But you don't conduct a conference supporting the restrictions on free speech in a public school on your taxpayer. Superintendent's gotta go! Who the hell does he think he is? Now let me tell you something. When you come to these rallies, you have to know something. You have to know that you're walking out onto a stage. You have to know that this is a theater. And the media is the director. Like Francis Ford Coppola. They're coming here to film a narrative. They're coming here to make you look bad. That Amy Silverstein in today's Dallas Observer should be ashamed of herself. Wait a minute, it gets better. On her Twitter feed, her banner is Je suis Charlie. So she's saying Je suis Charlie, but she's criticizing all of us. Absurd, and shame on the Dallas Observer for printing that garbage. It's defamation, it's smear, it's libel. You walk tall. We're living in an age where evil is good and good is evil. You never forget who you are. I am honored to stand here. I am honored to stand with Jolene and Ken and the Tea Party, who was but never give them what they're looking for. They want you to say something wrong. They want you to have a bad sign, because that becomes the front page. When we did the Ground Zero mosque rally, we had 35,000 people on 9/11 at Ground Zero. The counter protest had maybe 150. What was the headline the next day? Doing rallies. On what planet? So understand, you have a role here, and your role is educator. Your role, you are, each one of you are beautiful. Listen to me. And your message is beautiful. So please, be beautiful. Act beautiful. Be righteous. Make the cause proud. Je suis America. Thank you. I would like to turn the mic over to my colleague. USA! Where's that music? Where's that music now? I'd like to turn the mic over. And by the way, I brought hundreds of pencils. If you want to know what it means free speech. Because this is what the cartoonists were using. The cartoonists who were slaughtered. And let me tell you something. There were many things in that magazine I didn't like. I didn't like the anti-Christian stuff. I didn't like the anti-Jewish stuff. I didn't kill anybody. It's elemental. It's not, there's no, I love on MSNBC. It's nuance. It's complicated. No, it's not. They deliberately do it to confuse the people. And so you are the soldiers in this war. Don't think you're not. Because were those people in the buildings, were they wearing uniforms on 9/11 or 2001? Were they our soldiers? They were. And you are. And you are your own little media organization. Every one of you has a Twitter. Every one of you has a Facebook. If you don't, you better get with the program. Because I will tell you that my website now has what? 100,000 a day. I'm one person. Roberts is bigger. He's one person. And it gets shared like crazy. And that's how you get the news out. So your role here, without us, I'm shouting into the wilderness. And shouting into the wilderness is not free speech. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you, every one of you. I want to turn the microphone over to my colleague, my partner in crime, the other half of the dynamic duo, Mr. Robert Spencer.